or cost Lesnar, rather, the match with Shane McMahon, and then we see Goldberg versus Lesnar 2 happening for an event like WrestleMania 33 in 2017. So there's a lot of promise that goes with the Monday Night Raw brand, and I hope that Shane McMahon and Stephanie can get along a little bit longer, because I really appreciate what they've been doing for both shows. They haven't let their animosity for one another get in the way, and the competition really has not been as intensified as what a lot of people thought it was going to be. So with the competition not being as intensified as what people thought it was going to be, they are focusing on their respective shows and making their respective brands huge with the draft picks they both made. John Cena and Randy Orton gone out of SmackDown Live. Raw didn't get off their game with the drafting of Randy Orton and John Cena. Rather, they took advantage of opportunities of drafting other champions like Rusev and the tag team champions of New Day, who will benefit Monday Night Raw's tag team division. And man, does that division ever look huge. The tag team division for Monday Night Raw looks just as huge as SmackDown's division, with American Alpha and Breezango and so many other teams having the opportunities. The Usos to be tag team champions for the SmackDown brand. But Raw's tag team division looks amazing. With tag teams on there, we've got the tag teams like the New Day, Anderson and Gallows, a new team, just recently showing up on Monday Night Raw after getting away from AJ Styles. They're gone to Monday Night Raw to make a name for themselves as possibly future tag team champions. That's probably what we're looking at when it comes to Anderson and Gallows. Even though Raw did not draft John Cena and Randy Orton, man, did they ever get some ultimate coups, and coups that they can take advantage of. And I hope that they do take advantage of those opportunities. And let me say this too. I hope that Stephanie McMahon and McFoley get along for a little while longer, because I really appreciate how the respect they've shown for one another has really shone through for the brand. Because with the respect that they've shown for one another shining through, they are able to focus on Monday Night Raw. They're able to focus on the split brand of pay-per-views and the tours and make them even more impressive, far more impressive than what we have seen in comparison from the first draft, this draft. So there's a lot of promise that goes with Monday Night Raw, and I hope they keep Mick Foley as Raw General Manager for a little while longer, getting along with Stephanie before some confliction shows up between brands, and possibly Mick Foley goes from Raw to SmackDown, which could happen over the next few months. A return of Sasha Banks is something else that I would like to see. I would love to see Sasha Banks versus Nia Jax, if not for the Raw Women's Championship, to determine the number one contender for the Women's Championship. That would be a big way for Sasha Banks to return in a feud with Nia Jax, because we have yet to see competition presented to Nia Jax. And with how many women we have exclusive to the Raw Women's Division, that can happen, even if not with Sasha Banks. Even Dana Brooke, if you had to put Dana Brooke, the protege of Charlotte, in the ring against Nia Jax as a fan favorite, that would be something different to see for her. I want to see competition for her, as I do for Braun Strowman. If you're not going to do anything with the guy, you should send him over to SmackDown with the rest of the Wyatt family, because that guy can really go the distance for Monday Night Raw. All he needs is more of an opportunity given to him than what he's been given. Yeah, we may be focusing on the crowning of the first ever Universal Champion and four huge names in the way of Kevin Owens, Big Kaz, Roman Reigns, and Seth Rollins, two of the three members of the former Shield. And a lot of things have been focused on Raw, like the return of the Cruiserweight division, return and debut of that. But we can also focus on different things happening on Monday Night Raw, like Braun Strowman, who has not had any emphasis on him at all. I don't call putting him in the ring against names nobody's ever heard tell of and just winning within 1 to 2 minutes anything really productive happening for Braun Strowman. And after having had nothing happen productively for Braun Strowman, it's time to get the ball rolling creatively for someone like Braun Strowman. If not, send him over to SmackDown Live with the rest of the Wyatt family and just have him coming out of the side of Bray Wyatt and Luke Harper and Eric Rowan eventually, because that is what needs to happen in the fallout of everything for Braun Strowman if you're going to get something going for his character, as there are so many opportunities still out there on Monday Night Raw. Opportunities for Roman Reigns, even with how I've appreciated how they've handled the punishment of Roman Reigns. Opportunities for Rusev, who wants the focus to be on the United States Championship. But let me say this, in the fallout of the draft and how people feel Monday Night Raw did not come away with benefiting from the draft, they really did. With how Rusev is coming up, believing the focus should be on the United States Championship, how the tag team champions, the New Day, have been promoting Raw's tag team divisions that are going to be competing with SmackDown's tag team division in the upcoming weeks, as early as the fall of the Backlash, which is happening just on the 11th of September before Clash of Champions. This is really huge, what's happening on Raw. With them not having drafted the WWE champion and having to come up with their own concept, which is inadequate in the minds of SmackDown, they should have called it the Milky Way title in the mind of General Manager Daniel Bryan, which I appreciate for some comical reprieve. But with how they've been focusing on this Universal Championship and had to bring that title in, they are also putting emphasis on how they believe the focus should be on the United States Championship and be on the tag team titles. So with not having drafted the WWE Champion, here comes the opportunity for other divisions to kind of move in and take over, which is really, really huge. And with how Roman Reigns is now on the back burner, even though he's in the main events and not being rewarded from the fallouts of any of these main events after having been punished with a suspension after having failed the drug test, this opens up the door for more opportunities and people to take advantage of them. Example, prime example, Finn Balor showing up, winning a Fatal 4-Way match, Reigns winning a Fatal 4-Way match by pinning Chris Jericho in a Fatal 4-Way, and then we see Finn Balor versus Roman Reigns in a huge win for Finn Balor and a huge way to debut. You couldn't have asked for a bigger debut to have had by defeating Roman Reigns, a winner of a main event status level and a man who's main event of WrestleMania. That is huge, and now because of that, Finn Balor will benefit in the future, and we may be looking at Roman Reigns versus Finn Balor too. He said he wanted to face Finn Balor because he respected the hell out of him, and that could be a huge main event in the future for Raw to be looking at. Just so many main events in the future for Raw to look at are still out there, like Cesaro being in the main event with the likes of Sheamus. This Best of 7 series, really appreciate that. See, they're taking advantage of not having drafted the WWE Champion, which they wanted to do primarily. They didn't want to have to bring in the Universal Championship, but they say they take that title very seriously. But with them not having drafted the Champion, more opportunities are on the table and have been presented to Raw to take advantage of, like the Best of 7 series, although a number one contender for the championship may not be determined because of the Best of 7 series, just to determine who is the best between Sheamus and Cesaro. I really appreciate that. And I also appreciate how the tag team divisions and the U.S. title divisions have kind of moved in where they haven't drafted the WWE Champion. They may not have had to create this Universal Championship, but they say they take it very seriously, although it remains to be seen. I think they are. With the Fatal 4-Way to determine a new champion and the fallout of Finn Balor's injury, which was unfortunate circumstances, so many people were upset and pissed off over that. I understand why, but stranger things have happened in the wrestling business, and believe me when I tell you, for those of you who may have felt like you've been let down in the fallout of the draft for Monday Night Raw, Raw certainly have benefited, and they will show that more often as the draft progresses with the split brand of pay-per-views, the tours, and the opportunities to showcase their divisions like the U.S. title, the tag team titles, and the upcoming Cruiserweight division, which I am a huge fan of, and be it that we haven't seen it in at least 10 years, that's been a decade. It's going to be big seeing the Cruiserweight division move back in, returning and debuting. Really huge times are ahead for fans of Monday Night Raw, and you should take advantage of it. Don't choose SmackDown over Raw, at least not now. I know that a lot of people have drawn the line between Raw and SmackDown early on here, but I think that's just drawing a conclusion. Don't choose SmackDown over Raw just yet. Give it some time. Give it some time to get used to, and then choose your favorite show, because I think Monday Night Raw still has much of a chance to dominate the ratings and supremacy, with the third hour having a huge advantage over SmackDown's 2, because SmackDown's not going to 3 anytime soon. And I have brought this into the conversation. Consider at least cutting Raw back to 2 hours, as Nitro did in their last few years. They cut Nitro back from 3 to 2 hours after they realized 3 hours may be too much wrestling to offer wrestling fans weekly, because 3 hours of wrestling on TV every week is ridiculous. So you might want to consider cutting Raw back from 3 to 2 hours, but with that third hour still there, they have a huge advantage, and they had 3 draft picks to SmackDown's 2. So SmackDown kind of had to take advantage of having just 2 draft picks because they were a 2-hour show, to Raw's 3 draft picks because they were 3 hours, because Raw had some pretty huge draft picks they could have made. But they left the door open for SmackDown. They took advantage of it, so SmackDown pretty much had to capitalize on opportunities when they had chances, like they said they needed, for instance, the Intercontinental Champion, The Miz, and they got him with Maryse, just as Raw got Rusev with Lana as a package deal. So definitely, they did take advantage of opportunities, and they will continue to benefit as the draft progresses, although it remains to be seen. One can remain pretty confident that we will see that happen. I'm your host, Jonathan Clark. I feel confident for the future of Monday Night Raw. I don't know about you, so you can let me know in the comments of my video blog on my YouTube channel at JonathanClark22, with a tweet on my Twitter at JonathanClark1. You can send it my way on my Facebook page at HEW Entertainment, and on Google Plus at the same HEW Entertainment. Just some of the ways you can get in on the conversation, and let me know how you feel about Raw fearing and the fallout from the 2016 WWE draft. It was a far better draft than the draft that we saw 14, 15 years ago in 2002. without a doubt. And I think it's just a matter of wrestling fans getting used to this new era we've kind of come into, because that is what it is. And the future has never looked more promising than what it does right now with WWE. I recently shot on the State of the Address for WWE just last week here on my radio show, and I feel very confident with the state of address that I issued about WWE, and I feel very confident for the state of both brands heading into the future for World Wrestling Entertainment. But what do you feel about all this? Because your opinion is what matters the most at the end of every single radio show or video show on YouTube and on my radio forum on my website. Your opinion is what it comes down to, so get in on the conversation by all means. For now, I'm your host, Jonathan Clark, and I will leave it at that, and I will talk to you again next week.
Like what you hear? Tell us on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube.
I think it's so cute, and I think it's so sweet, how you let your friends encourage you to try and talk to me. But let me stop you there, oh, before you speak.
My name is no, my sign is no, my number is no. You need to let it go, you need to let it go, need to let it go. My name is no, my sign is no, my number is no. You need to let it go, you need to let it go, need to let it go. First you gonna say you ain't running game, thinking I believe in every word. Call me beautiful, sorry.